गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू अकाउंटेंसी क्लासेस ऑफ श्री महावीर इंटरनेशनल स्कूल। सो एज यू नो दैट वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द चैप्टर दैट इज पार्टनरशिप फंडामेंटल्स। एंड वन मोर थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू क्लियर दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यू सिलेबस दैट इज रिवाइज्ड सिलेबस देर इज नो चेंज इन दिस चैप्टर। देर इज नो टॉपिक दैट इज डिलीटेड फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर। सो जस्ट यू हैव टू स्टडी द फुल चैप्टर। ओके, सो इन आवर लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द कंसेप्ट दैट इज ऑफ पार्टनर्स लोन। ओके, पार्टनर्स लोन कैन बी ऑफ टू टाइप, दैट इज गिवन बाई ए पार्टनर और टेकिंग बाई ए पार्टनर। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट टूडे, दैट विल बी रेंट पेबल। रेंट पेबल टू अ पार्टनर, इन विच कंडीशन rent is payable to a partner? Suppose that it happens sometime that firm is using any partner's personal property as a business. Okay, so in that condition rent will be paid to the partner. Okay, so rent payable to a partner, what will be the treatment of this item? First, that it will be shown into P&L account, just same as partner's loan, that it will also be shown in P&L account, not in P&L appropriation account. And second account, that will separately be prepared of rent payable account. This item will be entered at two places. The first, it will be P&L account, and second, it will be rent payable account. There is no effect on P&L appropriation account and partner's capital account or current account. Okay, so this will be the concept of rent payable. Let's start with a question to understand this concept better way. Rent payable, try to remind this point also, just same as partner's loan, the rent payable will also be charged against profit, that if there is loss to the firm, in that condition also you have to pay the rent. Let's see the question number 20. P and Q are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 60:40. 60:40, this is their profit sharing ratio. On 1st April 2014, their capitals were 5 lakh rupees and 3 lakh rupees. This is the opening capital of both partners. During the year ended 31st March 2015, they earned a profit of 7,60,000. 7,60,000 is the profit that is shown by profit and loss account. The terms of partnership are: interest on capital is to be charged at the rate of 8% per annum. P will get commission at the rate of 3% on turnover. Turnover is the meaning of sales, that is given in the question. Q will get a salary of 5,000 rupees per month. Q will get commission of 5% on profits after deduction of interest, salary and commission, including his own commission. This topic we will discuss while solving the question. P is entitled to a rent of 20,000 rupees per month for the use of his premises by the firm. This is the rent that firm is using P's personal premises for his business. That's why firm will pay monthly rent to P. So this is the rent payable, and we will show this rent to profit and loss account. Partners' drawings for the year were 40,000 and 30,000. Turnover for the year was 20 lakh rupees. After considering the above factors, you are required to prepare the profit and loss appropriation account and capital accounts of the partners. So let's start with the formats first. P&L appropriation account for the year ended. What is the year ended in this question? That will be 31st March 2015. March 31st, 2015 will be the closing of this question. So format of P&L appropriation, that is date particular, sorry, particular amount, this will be the format. This is P&L appropriation account, and second you have to prepare, that is partners' कैपिटल अकाउंट। In this we will prepare date, particular, two columns for amount, that is for both partners P and Q. Then again same date, particular and two columns for amount. P and Q, date, particular, P and Q. Okay, so first of all, on 1st April their capitals were 5 lakh and 3 lakh. So right here, opening capital 2014 1st April, by balance BD, this is 5 lakh for P and 3 lakh for Q. During the year ended, they earned a profit of 7,60,000. This is the profit, but out of this profit, first we will deduct rent payable, because rent is shown in P&L account. So just I am making a draft of P&L account. Actually, this will be the process of P&L, that first of all, show the profit by profit for the year equals to 7,60,000. Then in debit side we will show to rent payable. Rent payable, what is the rent? 20,000 rupees per month, means 20,000 multiply by 12. So rent will be 2,40,000. So the net profit that should be transferred to P&L appropriation account, that will be 5,20,000. 760 minus 240, 5,20,000 is the profit that will be transferred to P&L appropriation account. This profit we will show in P&L appropriation account, that is by P&L account 5,20,000. Okay. The terms of partnership are, interest on the capital is to be charged at the rate of 8%. So show here two, interest on capital, that is for both partners P and Q. Their capitals are 5 lakh and 3 lakh. So we will write 8% on 5 lakh and second 8% on 3 lakh. So it will be 40,000 and for Q it will be 24,000. So total interest on capital will be 64,000, and this interest on capital will be transferred to their capital account also. This will be on closing date, means 2015 31st March, by interest on capital, that is 40,000 and 24,000. Okay. Next point, P will get commission at the rate of 3% on turnover. So right here, 2P's commission, that is 3% on turnover. What is the turnover? Turnover is rupees 20 lakh. So we will find 3% on turnover. So it will be 60,000 rupees commission of P. Next, Q will get a salary of 5,000 rupees per month. So we will write here to Q's salary, 5,000 rupees per month, means 60,000 will be the salary of Q. P's commission and Q's salary both will be transferred to their capital account also. So right here, by commission, commission is only for one partner, that is P, 60,000. And by salary, salary is given to only one partner, that is Q, means 60,000. Next point, Q will get a commission of 5% on profits after deduction of interest, salary and commission. to Q's commission, and for this amount we will prepare a working note, that is calculation of Q's commission. Actually, it is mentioned in the question that how Q will get his commission. He will get commission after deducting interest on capital, salary and commissions. Commissions which? P's commission also and his own commission also. But we don't have Q's commission. So first of all, out of this profit, we will deduct these three items. This will be the first process. So right here, total profits equals to 5,20,000. This is the total profit, less interest on capital. Interest on capital is 64,000. Then commission of P. P's commission is 60,000 and salary of Q, that is also 60,000. So total amount is 1,84,000. Deduct these items from this, it will be 3,36,000. Means first of all, out of total profit, we deducted these three items because still we have only these three items. We don't have Q's commission. So 3,36,000 is the profit after deducting these three items. But it is mentioned in the question that Q will get commission after deducting his own commission also from this profit. But we don't have commission, so we will apply the rule, that is rate upon 100 plus rate. So 3,36,000 multiply by, what is the rate of commission for Q? It is 5%. So 5 upon 105. 21, from 21 we can deduct this. It will be 16,000. 16,000 rupees is the commission of Q. So right here 16,000. Okay. Next point is that rent payable. So rent payable, that we have already shown in P&L account, there is no effect on P&L appropriation and partners capital account. Partners drawings. So right here drawings, on which date? There is no date for partners drawing, so we'll assume it as closing date. 31st March, two drawings. Amount of drawing is 40,000 and 30,000. But we don't have any rate of interest on drawings, so we will not provide interest on drawings. Suppose that if you have date in the question, then we have to mention interest on drawing also. But we don't have rate, so by which rate we will take interest on drawing? So there will be no interest on drawings, okay? Turnover for the year, that we have already mentioned. So now our question is completed, and now we will distribute the profit, that is divisible profit. So first of all, find the divisible profit here. 5,20,000 is the total of credit side, and the same 5,20,000 is the total of debit side. Out of 520, deduct these four items. So you will get a profit of 3,20,000. This 3,20,000 will be transferred to partner's capital account. To partner's capital account, that is P and Q. How they will distribute this profit? It is already given in the question that their profit sharing ratio is 60:40. 60:40 means that is 3/2. 3:2, okay? So distribute this profit in 3:2. 3,20,000 multiply by 3/5 and multiply by 2/5. The first will be 1,92,000 and second will be 1,28,000. This will be the distribution of profit, 192 and 128. The same profit distribution will be transferred to their capital account on same date by P&L appropriation account, 1,92,000 and 1,28,000. Now, just total of partner's capital account. It is 792,000. 792,000 is the total of P, and total of Q's capital account, it will be, I think we have missed one point, that is Q's commission. Yes, we will write Q's commission also here. I'm just writing here, by Q's commission, it is 16,000. So now total of this, 528,000, right? 792 and 528. Same amount will be transferred on the debit side, 792,000 and 528,000. Out of these, deduct these 1 point, then 752 and 528 minus 30, it will be 498. This will be the closing balance, means to balance CD. This will be the closing balance, okay? So what was there in the question? Again, just I'm summarizing this question, that first of all, you have given profit in the question, and out of this profit, we have to deduct rent payable, because rent is given in P&L account. It is charged against profit. So first we showed in P&L account, that was the total profit, 760,000. Out of this 760, we deducted, that is rent payable, 240,000. Then we got a net profit, that to be shown in P&L appropriation account. It will be 520,000. Out of this 520, we have provided interest on capital, P's commission, Q's salary. 3 points we have provided. After that, we got a condition in the question that Q will get his commission after deducting interest, commissions and salary. And in commission, his own commission was also included, but we don't have his own commission first. So from this profit, we deducted 3 items. Later on, we got amount of 336,000, and formula that we applied here, rate upon 100 plus rate, because in this profit already his own commission was included. So we got amount of 16,000. The 16,000 was transferred to P&L appropriation account, and then we got a profit of 320,000 that was distributed among the partners. In the same way, all the items that was related to their capital accounts was also transferred to their capital account, and closing balance, that is closing capital of the partners, we got here 752,000 for P and 498,000 for Q. Okay, so this was question number 20. In that, rent payable concept was cleared. Let's take another question. Now I'm going to solve here, that is question number 22. Yes, see here, question number 22. A and B are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio 1:2. Their capitals on 1st April 2018 were 4 lakh rupees and 6 lakh rupees respectively. As per partnership deed, A is to get a monthly salary of 15,000 rupees and interest on capitals is to be provided at the rate of 10% per annum and charged on drawing 12% per annum. During the year, A withdrew 30,000 and B withdrew 50,000. The firm incurred a loss of 60,000 rupees during the year ended 31st March 2019 before above adjustments. This is the main point in the question, that before doing all the adjustment, you have to first identify in the question that firm is incurring loss or profit. If there is profit in the question, in that condition also, we will provide interest on capital, salary, commission, whatever. But in this question, we have loss. So we will not provide any interest on capital, any salary to any partner, but interest on drawing we will charge. Okay? You are required to prepare an account showing the distribution of profits. We have to prepare one account that will show their distribution of profits. In this, we have to prepare only one account. So let's see P&L appropriation account. the same format. I think now you can easily make the formats, because in every question I'm just revising full format. Yes, so first of all we have to mention the loss. Loss we write the debit side to loss for the year, ₹60,000. Okay, we have to put in this account only interest on drawings. Interest on drawing is income for the firm, so it will be written in the credit side by interest on drawings. Partners are A and B. Their drawings are 30,000 and 50,000. And rate of interest is 12%. Check, is there any time in the question that when did they withdrew the amount? No, so we will assume it as 6 months. Okay? So the first interest is ₹1,800 and second will be ₹3,000. So total interest is ₹4,800. Your loss was 60,000. Out of the 60, 4,800 is adjusted. So you will get a net loss of rupees. Just deduct this amount. It is 55,200. So this 55,200 will be distributed among both partners by partners capital account, that is A and B. Check what is the ratio of their profit sharing, 1:2. So 55,200 multiplied by 1/3 and 2/3. Calculate this. For first partner it will be 18,400 and for second partner it will be 36,800. 18,400 and 36,800. This will be the distribution of loss between both partners. What was there? It is looking just like a simple answer, but when you will see the question, then you may get confused that what is there in the question. Again, just think the point here that when you have profits in the question, then easily you can provide them interest on capital, salary, commission, means all the appropriation, because that are appropriation of profits. Okay, but in this question you have loss, means firm is suffering a loss of ₹60,000, then how it can provide interest on capital, salary, because these all are appropriation of profits, but you don't have profits, you have loss. So don't provide any interest on capital, salary, commission, whatever is in the question, but interest on drawing is charged. Why? What is the reason behind it? Because it is income for the firm, this is not expense. So loss can be adjusted by the income. And loss can be reduced after charging this income. So now your loss is 55,200, that is distributed among the partners, means that is beared by the partner. Both partners will take this loss in their profit sharing ratio, that is 1:2. Okay. Again, I'm solving one question, that is question number 23. Question number 23 we will solve in our next video, because right now we have lack of time. So this type of questions are easy for you, but you may get confused only when you will read the question. So try to understand the concept very carefully. And one more thing I want to clear, that whenever you study the accountancy, you should make your own notes. You should not depend on your teacher's notes. You should prepare your own notes that is understandable for you. Every concept you should write. Just don't think that, yeah, I have understood and now I can easily solve the question. No, now you have understood, but after 4 days, 5 days, or after 1 month, when you will revise the chapter, then you don't have any notes, any concept in your mind. So whenever you study the point, you should write every notes, you should write every concept to revise the chapters very carefully. And one more query I got from your classmates, that we are just forgetting the previous chapters as we are going further in the course. So we are just forgetting the previous chapters. So one thing for this that you should give one day for revising the chapters. You should give one day in a week for revising the chapters. This will be the better way for you. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you so much. In next video, we will discuss the next question.